أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له من دون الله وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله رب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس. الحمد لله الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. ثم أما بعد، My dear respected brother and sister Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, we'll start again to continue our topic where we started before, the disease of the heart. And as we said, my brother and sisters, whatever happened in this dunya, whatever you can collect in this dunya, whatever you can get from this dunya, nothing will help you. Except if you come inshallah in front of Allah Azza wa Jal with one thing. So Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that in the Quran. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. Nothing will help you. Your wealth and your family. What can help me? إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except the person who come to Allah Azza wa Jal with a pure heart, with a good heart. This person, Allah Azza wa Jalla will accept all his deeds. This person, he will save himself. This person, his heart will benefit him. So my brother, to come in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla with this good heart, you must maintain this heart. You must always check up. Like now, when they say, if you pass 45 years, whatever, go and make check with the doctor every time, every 6 months for blood check and for heart test and all the things to make sure you're healthy. So you can live longer. Or you can live on your life, you live healthy. So what about the heart? You need to maintain it for Allah Azza wa Jal. So you need to clean your heart from any disease. Because my brother, as we said before, if you remember, when you die, all your disease will die. You're not going to have any more extra cholesterol or problem in the heart or blood pressure. All the disease died. The disease will wake up after you die, the disease of the heart. The hatred, the envy, the jealousy, the show off, all the things. That will start come up again. And that will really, really affect you. Because you need a good heart in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. But all your life, you never maintain your heart. You never look at your heart. You never search inside of your heart to see if you got any disease, to clean it. To see if you got any run, as Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that in the Quran, كَلَّا بَالْرَانِ. All the ma'asiyah on top of each other, it make a rust on your heart. You never clean the rust. And Rasulullah Sallam said, the cleaning of the rust of the heart to make istighfar. But nobody maintain his heart. That's why my brother, we talk about the things so everyone he can start to maintain his heart, start look at his heart. What is my problem? What I've got in my heart? Did I have envy in my heart for my brother in Islam? Did I have jealousy from my sisters, for the sisters together? Did I have hatred to any of my brothers? All of us will know the story. I'm not going to say it all, but the person, the Prophet ﷺ said, a man is going to enter the masjid now and he's one of the people of Jannah. We know the story. And Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As went to see what this guy do every day to be guaranteed. The Prophet ﷺ guaranteed a Jannah for him. All what he found about this man, he when he sleep in the night, has no hatred against any Muslims. That's it. When he sleep, he forgive all his brothers. He had no hatred for any Muslims. This man, the Prophet ﷺ said, guarantee for him the Jannah for only these things. The Prophet ﷺ never mentioned how much prayer he is to pray. How much fast he is to fast. How much zikr he is to do. How much? No. Just when he sleep in the night, my brothers, he doesn't have any envy or any hatred or any jealousy or anything against the Muslims. It let him go to Jannah for this reason. How many of us before he sleep, he search in his heart. Did I have any hatred against my brother? Any brother, some brother today talk to me in the wrong way. Some brother today, he abused me. He like me, like make me feel bad, whatever. Did I have anything against my brother? Did anyone think about that? Or when you sleep, you feel bad. Oh, this brother today, he did that for me. He's not a good person. He's what? You have something in your heart. Clean it, my brother. Clean it every day. Maintain your heart every day. If you have any rust in your heart, make istighfar before you sleep. So Allah Azza wa Jalla can forgive you, inshallah. So that's how my brother, we talk about the heart. Because wallahi the heart is most important things. Illa man ata Allah biqalbin salim. You're gonna do all you did. You're gonna fast. You're gonna pray. You're gonna make hajj. You're gonna give zakah. You're gonna give sadaqah. You're gonna make zikr. You're gonna make all the things. But if your heart, inside of, of your heart, you have show off, you love people, your heart loves people to talk about you, all what we're talking about, salah, zakah, sawm, hajj, zikr, whatever, is not acceptable. Allahu Akbar. I'm working very hard. I make zikr every day 1,000 times. I read part of the Quran every day. I give sadaqah every day. I pray every day all my fard in the masjid. And I pray 12 rak'ah every day and more. And I make hajj. And if I make umrah, if I can make umrah, I make a lot of things. But Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. You bring whatever you have did, salah, zakah, sawm. Why? Because you used to do it for somebody else, not for Allah Azza wa Jalla. Your heart loves to show off. It's gone. It's finished. Nothing. هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. Dust. Nothing. So my brother, the heart is the main thing. It's very important. If you don't control your heart, if you don't maintain your heart, if you don't clear your heart, you got a problem, my brother. All your good deed is very big risk for your good deed. For any of these diseases, anything, hatred, envy, show off, whatever. So as I said, my brother, today I was talking in the khutbah. If you learn and you don't implement these things in your life, there's no use. If we learn things and we don't start practicing our life, what is the use? I know Allah Azza wa Jal tell me in the Quran, riba is haram. I read it in the salah. I read in the Quran, the Shaykh talk about it. And I listen. And I know it. But what's happened after that? I eat riba. Allah Azza wa Jal tell me in the Quran, zina is haram. I know it. I heard it. I read it. All the things. And what I do? I look in the haram. That's a zina. إن العين لا تزني وإن زناها النظر. The eye makes zina, and the zina of the eye to look. I know backbiting is haram. And I hear it, and I listen to the sheikh talk about it. But I still backbite. So all the things, my brother, if you know and you don't practice it, it's actually against you. If you don't know, it's different. It's easy. Because I never know backbiting is haram. I used to backbite, but I never know it's haram. But when you know, it's become against you. It's finished. You have no excuse in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. When your son makes something wrong, and you tell him, why do that? Wallahi, that I don't know it's wrong. You cannot punish him. He doesn't know. You teach him. If he does it again, and they tell you, I don't know. No, I told you already. You know it. Now you are lying. So that's how, my brother, wallahi, the ilm is not just to listen. The ilm is to practice whatever you get ilm. Whatever you have. That's very important for us as a Muslims, not just to know the things without practicing the things. That's why, inshallah, today also we're going to talk about one kind of heart. It's very dangerous. If you have this kind of heart, my brothers, very big risk. We call it al-qalb al-qasi, the hard heart. Very hard. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned this heart in the Quran so many times. When he said in the Quran, talking to Bani Israel. Bani Israel, my brothers, Allah Azza wa Jalla make them a great example for us. Because He chose them first. And He gave them more prophets than us. He gave us only one prophet. For them, as some ulama said, 125,000 prophets. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, He chose them to take the message from the prophet, to continue to give it to everywhere. And He showed them so many miracles. But after He showed him the miracle, these people, these two straight away, like as we know in Ashura, after they passed the Red Sea, as soon as they see a great miracle, Allah Azza wa Jal killed Fir'aun and his army for them. As soon as they passed, they said, اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم عليه. Ya Musa, make for us God. Make for us a statue so we can worship the statues as God. As these people, they saw people they worship statues. So they wanted to be like them. So Allah Azza wa Jal said, ثم قست قلوبهم من بعد ذلك فهي كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة. الله أكبر. After they saw the miracle, When you see a miracle, my brothers, your heart should become soft. Your heart should start become connected to Allah Azza wa Jal. When you see a miracle, your heart should be changed. And that's the normal person. The normal believer, the one who believes in Allah Azza wa Jal. As soon as you saw a miracle, your heart start become soft. So many people, they used to be kafir in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's time. And when they saw something from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they used to become Muslim straight away. Straight away. We're talking about the man, he was walking and the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he came in front of him and the man, he wanted to test the Prophet. And they hide something in his hand and they said, if you tell me what in my hand, I will believe in you. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I will tell the thing in your hand to tell you who is me. More challenge. So he said, open your hand. When you open his hand, the stone, it was having a little stone in his hand. And the little stone, they said, you are Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this guy, as soon as he saw this miracle, he became Muslim straight away. He cannot deny it. And Bani Israel did these things in front of them. But subhanAllah, after the miracle, the heart become hard. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said, من بعد after they saw the miracle, فهي كالحجارة, they are like stone. There is anything stronger than stone? Allah Azza wa Jalla said yes. أو أشد قسوة, even stronger. My brother asked any doctor, go Dr. Muhammad, like, would ask, if you open a heart, is a meat, isn't it? It's not stone. But can you believe this heart can be more stronger than stone? Yes. When you deny Allah Azza wa Jalla, you become like stone. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَوَيْلُ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبِهِمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Ya Allah. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَيْل, as we said before, my brothers, it's a leak in Jahannam. In Jahannam. Jahannam asking Allah Azza wa Jalla to protect her from this leak. Because it's more hotter than Jahannam. So this Jahannam, this leak, for the people, the heart become hard. And they're not making zikr to Allah. They don't remember Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's why I said when the person, his heart become hard, because he deny Allah Azza wa Jalla. He deny Allah Azza wa Jalla. He doesn't care about Allah, he doesn't care about anything else. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to always make dua to Allah Azza wa Jal. My brother, qalb in Arabic, qalb, if you put anything upside down, you change the situation of the things. Qalb. That's why we call it qalb, because the qalb can change any time. Today you love somebody, tomorrow you hate him. And the qalb is not in your hand. The heart is not in your hand. So the Prophet said, he used to make dua to Allah, Allahumma ya mathabbitul qulub. Ya Allah, ya one who support the heart. ثبت قلبي على دينك. Make my heart never change away from your deen. Support my heart to stay all the time on your deen. Because there is hadith of Allah, يصبح الرجل مؤمنا, a person wake up in the morning, believer. ويمسي كافرا, in the night he become kafir. That's the time of us now. ويمسي مؤمنا, and he sleep, ويمسي كافرا, and he sleep kafir, ويصبح مؤمنا. He wake up in the morning, a believer. And then he changed, and the heart's not stable anymore. يَبِيعُ دِينَهُ بِعَرَضٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا قَلِيلٍ. He can sell his deen with anything of the dunya. They're asking him, come on the TV, talk about the Islam. Oh, how much are you going to give me? $10. $10,000. Oh, good money, I'll come. What's $10,000? Nothing. But he can sell his deen with anything. And we see it in our country now. So many people come to talk against Islam for a little bit of money, but they don't care. So the people, the heart become hard, my brothers. These people, they are very dangerous. What is the signs of a person, his heart start become hard? Like when you get a flu, you start sneeze, high fever, things like that, you know? So what can you know yourself? How can you know yourself if my heart start change? If my heart start become hard? So the first things, my brother, subhanAllah, if you start see yourself having one of these things, there is alert, wake up, something wrong. If you start to become lazy, from doing the good things, from the salah, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned about the munafiqeen, when they used to come to the salah, my brother, لا يأتون الصلاة إلا وهم كسالى. When they come to the salah, they are very lazy. They don't want to come. But they have to come because people, they will talk, oh, we didn't see this person today. He's not coming for the salah. He's coming because he's worried if the people say he didn't come today. So he comes, but in his heart, he don't want. And also Allah said, وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاؤُونَ النَّاسِ. If they go to the salah, all right, I'm coming. I'll do something and then I'll come like, no, excuse. So you come, and if you come to pray, as soon as see people, Allahu Akbar, I'm the best. He pray nicely, he pray like, he take time, because there's people around him. But if there is no people, maybe about 4 or 5 seconds, he finishes dhuhr, alhamdulillah. That's it, like quickly, because he doesn't have time, I've got so many things. But if there is people, as long as the people sitting, I'm praying dhuhr. 1 hour, I will pray dhuhr, no problem. So I can show the people how much I'm good, you know? Like, watch me. Like, you know, I'm praying dhuhr now. If you can talk, you will talk to the people. So the first time, my brother, if you see yourself lazy from doing something good for Allah Azza wa Jal, salah, zikr, whatever, and you don't, when you make it, it's very hard on you, your heart, there is something affecting your heart. I'm not saying you become careful, no, but there's something coming to your heart. You don't have the feeling to do things for Allah Azza wa Jalla. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, as we always mentioned that, when he used to become tired, he used to tell Bilal, Ya Bilal, give us rest. He said, enough Bilal, I'm tired. What is the rest, Ya Rasulullah? Let us pray. That is the rest of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Our rest is not to pray. Come on, man, I don't want to pray now, I want to rest. Come on, stop reading Quran, Alhamdulillah, we read Alhamdulillah one ayah, that's enough. Like, why we read too much? But Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his rest was in the salah. He enjoys the salah. Big difference, my brother. Also, one of the things, it can make alarms for you. Wake up, something wrong with your heart. If you hear the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jal, but you never take any wisdom, you never take any, like, you know, you don't care. The ayat in front of you is nothing. Especially if you understand what you read. Especially if you understand, like, I understand if somebody read but doesn't understand, what is going to get? No problem. But now you got the Quran and you got translation. And Allah said in the Quran, فَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مَنْ يَخَافُ وَعِيدِ. Remind with the Quran the people they scared of my warning. Because Allah, my brother, gave us warning in the Quran. He gave us so many warnings in the Quran. If you don't look at the warning of Allah Azza wa Jal and you wake up, if you don't see Allah Azza wa Jal said, for the people they eat the riba, they will fight Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in judgment day, and you don't wake up to leave the riba, your heart become hard. Your heart doesn't feel anything, it's finished. He doesn't be scared of Allah Azza wa Jal's warning. If you don't see the warning of Allah Azza wa Jal, if you not be on the Islam, you're going to be in the hellfire, you don't care. If you don't see the warning of Allah Azza wa Jal, for whatever Allah tell us in the Quran, for backbiting, for whatever, anything, and you don't care, there is something wrong with your heart. Your heart starts to become hard. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. The real believer, if you mention Allah, his heart starts to become scared. I'm listening, that's Allah. وَجِلَتْ الْوَجَلْ humility, خَوْف fearing Allah Azza wa Jal. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ, and if they hear the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jal and they understand, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, they increase the belief. But if you hear the ayat and you understand the ayat and your iman, it doesn't increase, my brother, it doesn't like go high a little bit, there is some problem. That's why the Sahaba, when they used to sit with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, one day they were sitting with him. And after they finish, they went to home. And they start like mixing with the family, the children. And one of the Sahaba came crying. Abu Bakri meet him. Say, what's wrong, Ya Hanzala? What's wrong? Why are you crying? He said, Nafaqa Hanzala. Hanzala is munafiq. Hanzala is hypocrite. He said, why? He said, when we sit with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we feel our iman increase. We sit with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we heard, Qala Allah, Qala, whatever Allah said. And our iman go very high. But as soon as we go home, we forget about it and we sit with the wives and the children. I am munafiq. I am not a good person. So Abu Bakr said, if you are that, I'm same. So I'm also munafiq. Let's go to the Prophet ﷺ. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, when we come to sit with you, we feel our iman increase. But when you go home, mix with the children and the life. And Ya Rasulullah, he laughed. He said, Wallahi, if you stay in the situation while you are with me, the angels will come to greet you on the road. Because that's very high. But sa'atun wa sa'a, like 1 hour, to do it for Allah Azza wa Jalla, to concentrate about your ibadah. That's why we're not asking people to come to the masjid 24 hours every day, or even 5 hours every day. Your salah every day doesn't take even 1 hour out of your day. Twice or three times, maybe lecture in the week, how long it takes between Maghrib and Isha, and that's it. That's all what you've been asked to do. And you implement these things to practice it in your life. That's very important. You don't have to learn. You cannot, my brother, come here. We come for how many years now? We're taking lesson after lesson, we're taking topic after topic, but still nobody changed anything in his life. But he just come because he must come. It's a habit. I must come. It's good. Stay calm. Don't let the shaitan do no, don't come because I'm not doing anything. No, that's the way of the shaitan. But you must start implement what you learn in your life. You must start practicing. So that the Sahaba, when they used to see themselves, the iman go down, they think they're hypocrite. No, that's normal life. But it's very important. When you hear that the ayat, your iman increase. Your iman go high. You feel your heart connect to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Another thing, my brother, if it's happened to you, there is alert. Something wrong with your heart. But when you see the people dying every day in front of your eyes, and you don't change. When you go to the grave, and you see people dying there from 10 years ago, or 20 years ago, you can see the date, they put the date on the graves. And of course there is people die hundreds and thousands years ago. But we're talking about people, we can't see the date in front of our eyes. This brother Muhammad, he's been in the grave for how long? This brother Ahmad, he's been in the grave for how long? This brother Ali, this brother whatever, the dates. But when I see it, nothing changed. Nothing happened to me. I go, bury another person, I come back home, nothing. Nothing. I even forget about everything. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. I went to the grave. I bury my own brother. He used to sit with me in the masjid. We used to listen to the sheikh together. We used to pray together. We used to read Quran together. We used to make dhikr together. I went and I bury him. He's very close to me. But who remember him now? Who make dua for him now? It's finished. He's gone. My brother, if your heart like that, if you bury people every day or every time, and you don't change, something wrong with your heart. Your heart become hard. He doesn't get the wisdom. He doesn't get anything from that. If you go to visit the graves and you come back again, and some people when they go to the grave, my brother, I cannot take it, wallahi, subhanallah. We're going to bury somebody, and the brother, they're laughing with each other. Brother, you cannot laugh in this place. You cannot laugh in this place. This place is not for laughing. This place to remember that the day, one day you're going to come. This is the place, one day you're going to come, and you will be thrown in the same hole like that, and everybody will leave you. And wallahi, the most hard day, the first day of the death. Either to be the best day of your life, or either to be the most bad day of your life. The first night in the grave, my brothers, the hardest day all our life, in our life. Either to be the best day of your life, or either to be the worst day of your life. So it's not easy to go there and you laugh, and you don't think about it. So if you go there, my brothers, and you come back again, and you feel like nothing in your heart, there is alert. Tell you something wrong with your heart. Your heart starts to become hard. You see the people dying in front of you, you see the people in the grave, but nothing changed. So you must wake up. Also, when you see any disaster, my brother, like when we see the tsunami, what's happening, 200,000 people die in a second, like that. What is changing your heart? It doesn't give you a feeling Allah in a second can get you anyway. In a second. These people, they were enjoying on the beach and whatever they do. And all of us, we see how many cameras they record the things. And they saw the water come, they thought like it's a normal wave. But سبحان الله the wave comes and take everybody. All the 200,000 people die in a second. What it change in your heart? What it make your heart? No, nothing. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَلَوْلَا إِذَا جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسَنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. When they see the hard things, they start to make dua, Ya Allah, please forgive us. And what after that? When everything is stable, everything is fine, قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, the heart become hard again. So some people in the situation, in the bad situation, yeah, they make dua to Allah Azza wa Jalla, but after that, ولكن قصد قلوبهم وزين لهم الشيطان ما كانوا يعملون. The shaitan start to become again to tell them, no, don't worry, you are safe. This for the other people, not for you. Australia is too far from any disaster like that. Don't worry, alhamdulillah, in a very nice place. And so the shaitan let him come again to start continuing in his life, normal, back. No, my brother, Allah, when you see something like that, wake up. There is alert. Allah Azza wa Jal give you to wake up. One of the things also, when you love the dunya more than the hereafter. If you love the dunya more than the hereafter, my brother, there is something wrong with your heart. If you become happy for things coming to you from the dunya, money, whatever, and you become sad if you give something for sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, you love the dunya more than the hereafter. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal said, لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسَوْ عَلَى مَا فَتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَحُ بِمَا أَتَاكُمْ. Don't feel sorry for what you left, or what gone. And don't become very happy for what comes. Because can be changed any time again. Right? بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. You love the dunya, but the hereafter is better and staying forever. You love the dunya, you love the money, you love everything. I'm not saying, I always mention that. Be rich. Be the most rich person in the world. But my brother, don't love the dunya. Don't make the dunya in your heart. One of the salaf, he's asking a man, he got one dirham. He said, this dirham, like $1, belong to who? He said, belong to me. That's my dirham. That's my money. He said, it will belong to you if you give it for sake of Allah. As long as he's with you, if you die like that one, the dollar with you, he's not belong to you. He's belong to your relative. They will take it from you. But if you give it for sake of Allah, he become yours. It's going to be rewarded in your book. You see how these people used to think, my brother? Opposite than us. And that's how they learn from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Aisha, Ya Aisha, what left from the sheep? The Prophet has sheep. He's coming, he's angry. She said, all the sheep gone except the shoulder. Because you know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves the shoulder. He said, Ya Aisha, no, you are wrong. You are wrong. The shoulder is gone. What we're going to eat is gone. It's going to go to the toilet. But the rest of the sheep is belong to us now, reward. That's how the Prophet ﷺ is teaching the Sahaba. That's why the Salaf, they learn. That's why this man, he said, the dollar is not belong to you. If you give it for sake of Allah, it become yours. If you keep it and you die while you have this dollar, your relative will take it, it's not yours. Or if you eat with this dollar, of course you have to eat, but still, it's going to toilet. So when you think about it, my brother, and you love the dunya more than the hereafter, there is Allah, there is something. Wake up, my brother. Also, if you don't have the respect of Allah Azza wa Jalla in your heart, the heart, my brother, is the king of the body, and the organ is the soldier. The king moving the soldier, tell the soldier what to do. So whatever the heart love, he's asking the soldier to do, and the soldier does. So if he loves to make zina wal ayyazu billah, he will order the soldiers to do that. The eyes will start, look, the tongue will start, talk, and after that he's going to commit zina, because he loves zina wal ayyazu billah. If he loves to backbite, he's going to order the soldier, the tongue, to talk, and the tongue is going to start talk. He's going to start backbite. So he control. If he loves to eat haram, he's going to order the hand to take the haram. If he loves to walk to the haram, he's going to order the feet to walk to the haram. So the heart is the king of the body. What can change the heart? If you have respect to Allah Azza wa Jal in your heart, respect of the command of Allah Azza wa Jal in your heart, as long as you have this respect, my brother, in your heart, the heart will start to control the soldiers to do what Allah Azza wa Jal wants. Because you have respect. When you have respect of Allah Azza wa Jal, my brothers, when you be alone, nobody sees you. Nobody. And you can do the ma'asiyah, you can do the bad deed, because no one sees me. But your heart tells you, respect Allah. Allah's watching you. If you don't do it, my brothers, your heart become hard. You don't care about Allah Azza wa Jal. لا تجعل الله أهون الناظرين عليك. Don't make Allah Azza wa Jal the most little one he look at you. Allah, wallahi, my brother, if you think about some ma'asiyah you do secretly, and I ask you, you ask me to do it in front of everybody now, no way. No way. So you worried about the people, and you don't want it from Allah Azza wa Jal. Is this how your heart tells you? To worry about people. And these people, even Allah Azza wa Jal can let them forget whatever you have done in a second. In a second they will forget. I did bad thing in front of everybody, but after that everybody forget it. But Allah Azza wa Jal, وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيَّ. Allah never forget. Never ever. Never ever. And what you hide now from the people, Allah Azza wa Jal will show it in front of billions and trillions of angels and mankind. The day of judgment day, my brothers, it's a very hard day. You're hiding things now from people, and you make yourself the best person, and Allah Azza wa Jal, if He did cover you, everybody will know what you used to do in the dunya. So think about it, wallahi. Now, I'm showing myself, I'm the best man, I'm not doing anything, alhamdulillah. And then you're going to see me, inna lillahi wa inna, that's what you used to do. And you used to make yourself in front of us the best man, and you used to talk about this and talk about that, but between you and Allah Azza wa Jal, you do bad things, I won't like it. I won't be happy to be impressed like in front of everybody like that. So my brother, do it from now. That's why if your heart starts to have respect to Allah Azza wa Jal, honor to Allah Azza wa Jal, wallahi, my brother, you will think twice. You will think twice to do anything haram between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. And if you do that, straight away, because all of us, we got hidden things. Nobody can say, I'm clean. Nobody. Nobody. I'm not talking about this. Because if he does bad things, quickly, go back to Allah Azza wa Jal, say, Allah, forgive me. I'm sorry. Astaghfirullah. Give some sadaqah. Do some things. And cover yourself. Because one of the things we're going to talk about it, people, they make the ma'asiyah and they come in the morning to say, oh, yesterday I make that. Why you tell, brother? No, I'm not hiding anything. No, hide it. Don't let anybody knows about it. Because the Prophet said in the hadith, كل أمتي معاف. Allah will forgive all my ummah, except who? المجاهرون. The person Allah Azza wa Jalla cover him in the night, he make ma'asiyah, but Allah Azza wa Jalla didn't let anyone knows about it. And in the morning, he come between his friend, yesterday I made that, yesterday I went to the girl, yesterday. Cover it, my brother. He cover you. Don't take the cover of Allah Azza wa Jalla away from you. And make istighfar to Allah Azza wa Jalla. But the person who do the ma'asiyah secretly and he doesn't care, that's the person who's going to be sorry in the judgment day. Also, my brother, a person who when he have hard heart, he doesn't have mercy in his heart. Like you see people, subhanallah, when you come to talk about orphan or talk about people suffering some way or whatever, he doesn't have any soft heart to him. He doesn't care. It's not my problem. As long as, alhamdulillah, my child is safe, as long as my husband is safe, as long as my wife is safe, as long as my mother is safe, and my father, my sisters, my brothers, my friend, who cares about anyone else? He doesn't have mercy in his heart. If you see animal being slaughtering in the wrong way, he doesn't feel so in his heart for this animal. It's just an animal. Who cares? It's a soul, my brothers. It's a soul. The Prophet used to feel sorry and used to have mercy for the camel when he come to cry to him. He said, who the owner of this camel? The camel come complaining to the Prophet about one of the Sahaba. He used to let him work hard and doesn't give him enough food. He come to the Prophet and complain, Ya Rasulullah, my owner, he pushed me too much. He doesn't give me enough food. And the camel is crying to the Prophet and Muhammad sallam, he was shouting to the Sahaba, how come you don't have mercy? Have mercy for everyone on the earth. يَرْحَمُكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Allah will have a mercy for you. So a person doesn't have mercy, my brother, his heart got problem. You must have mercy if If almost I say, wallahi, my brothers, wallahi, your wife is not angels. He's not angel. Your husband is not angel. He will make mistakes. Have a mercy for him. Have a mercy for her. Wallahi, if you do that, Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, وَمِنْ آيَتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا A miracle to create Eve from Adam, عليه السلام. لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا سَكِينَةً Peaceful in the house. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً He make between you love. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً Mercy. If you don't have mercy for your wife, won't you make mistakes, my brother? Your heart is hard. Something wrong with your heart. Think about it. My wife, she make mistakes. No. I won't let it go. I must let her know. I must do this. I must do that. I must shout. I must have a mercy, my brother. Allah will have a mercy for you. She's a human being. She make mistakes. As you also make mistakes. And she should have mercy for you. She should forgive you. She should try with you one and two and three and hundred and million times to save the family. Because her children. He's not angels. He's not angel. She's not angel. If you have a mercy in your heart, my brother, you will look at the situation in different direction, wallahi. But if you don't have mercy, you cannot forgive. No, I'm not going to let it go. She always do it. Wallahi, think about yourself. You always do bad things for Allah Azza wa Jalla. And as soon as you say, Ya Allah, forgive me, Allah forgive you straight away. And that's what Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned in the hadith. If one of you make bad deed, and it will be written on him, on his book. And if he said, Ya Allah, forgive me, Allah will take it off for him. No condition, nothing. Just ask Allah with sincerity to forgive you. It's finished, Allah forgive you. But when your wife, she comes to ask you for forgiveness, please, I'm sorry, I'm not going to do that again. And she does it before 100 times. No, you don't learn. I have to punish you, I have to do that, I'll destroy my family. And you do it million times for Allah Azza wa Jal, and Allah Azza wa Jal every time forgive you. My brother, we have to implement what we learn in our life. You cannot just learn and then you go back home and your wife should ask you mercy. No. What you heard? You just heard now from the Shaykh. No, what I heard in the masjid, it's different. But in my house, I have to punish you, I have to destroy my family, No, my brother, it's not right. Your heart become hard. Think about it for your children, for everything. And also, the person doesn't like care about orphan or about poor people or about whatever we said about it now. Also, you got a problem. So, inshallah, we'll stop today because next week, inshallah, we're going to talk about the reason for our heart to become hard. What is the reason? That's all what we say, science. You can see things. Oh, these things happen to me, so be careful. So inshallah, we're gonna know also another reason, inshallah, next week, inshallah, about the heart. Because wallahi, my brother, it's really important. If we don't maintain our heart, like any one of us, he got car, he go to the mechanic to do service, to maintain his car. Otherwise, his car is not going to work. Your house, if you don't maintain your house, if you live in the house and don't maintain your house, you're going to see the roof is going to fall one day on your head. You have to do some things, you have to clean the gutter, you have to do this, you have to cut the grass, you have to maintain the house. You cannot just live in the house like that. What about your heart? It's very important. If you don't maintain your heart, my brothers, wallahi, one day you will see your heart will be on top of the heart run, rust. And one after one, my brother, nothing can reach to the rear because that's like run, that's like rust, to become too much. And somebody talk to you, it doesn't go through because the rust stop it. That's why the people is hard. It become hard because of all the rust. That's why we need to learn how to clean this rust. We must clean it. We must work on that. It will take time, take as much as take. But inshallah, as long as Allah Azza wa Jalla knows your sincerity, know your honesty, one day wallahi Allah Azza wa Jalla will make your heart pure. He will make your heart clean. No rust. You're going to see wallahi, my brother, when you stand behind the Shaykh and you understand one ayah and he read it, you will feel yourself, you cannot control yourself. You will start crying. You will start crying. You feel, you have that touch with the Quran. When you hear something from Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you will take it straight away. The Sahaba, the woman, they used to wait for the husband come from work. After they used to come from work to go to the Masjid of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to learn. As soon as he entered the house, Assalamu Alaikum, Alaikum Assalam, what did you learn from the Prophet? Straight, that's what she's worried. How much did you get? Did you get money today? Did you get work today? No money, nothing. The first thing she asked about it, what did you get from the Prophet? Knowledge. Ilm. so he can be in our house. So we can practice together. Because the wife, her goal is to take her husband's hand, and the husband's goal to take his wife's hand to go to Jannah together. That's why they wanted to practice the deen in their life. That's why, wallahi, my brother, like, put this way, like, always I say, if you make a triangle, and you write Allah Azza wa Jalla's name on top, and you write on the side, wife, and on the other side, husband. Wife and husband too far from each other. Because that's how the triangle, isn't it? Too far. Allah, wife, husband. We need to make them close. The only way is both of them to move to Allah Azza wa Jalla. They will be very close to each other. The only way to make husband and wife to be close to each other is both of them to start to move to Allah Azza wa Jalla. When they move, look at the gap, start to become smaller. Until to get to Allah Azza wa Jalla, they're going to be very close to each other. But as long as they are far away from Allah Azza wa Jalla, they are far away from each other. That's how exactly, if you wanted to get with anybody, you want to be close to him, get to him closer through Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's why, wallahi, my brother, we need to maintain our heart, inshallah. Next week, inshallah, we'll continue about the heart. And that's why I said, like, it's a very important topic. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to soften our heart and to connect our heart to him, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاكم الله خيرا.